So, dear students, in the continuation of the last class, today we will discuss the one more concept, that is rounding of the uncertain digits. So here, suppose if in our experiments, if you are measuring the physical quantities and finally we will get some results. In that results, by using calculator or by using multiplication or division or addition, we will get final result. So in that final result, if it is suppose, let in case of g value, if you found the g value is 9.8167823... so on, like this. If that is the case, then how to round off this value? That means there must be a procedure. So that's why we have certain points. So based on these points, then we will round off the numbers. So here, actual value is 9.8. But what about these digits? Suppose if you take any other measurements, then how to round off these digits? That's why we have certain rules. Now let me write down those rules. The first one is, if the digit to be dropped is smaller than 5, then the preceding digit should be left unchanged. That means same, we won't change the number. For example, if a number is given like 2.432, now we want only what is the significant figure here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So the significant figure is 4, but we want only 3 significant. That means we want to eliminate this number. That means we want to round off this up to only 3. So here we want to eliminate this 2. Now observe here. If the digits to be dropped is smaller than 5, that means 2 value here, 2 is less than the 5, then the preceding digit should be left unchanged. That means this value should be left unchanged. So that means 2.43. So this is answer. Now finally, what is the significant figure? 3 significant figure. So that means we want to round off this value up to 3 significant figure. Right. Suppose if this value is greater than 5, then what happens? Now that is second case. Now second point. if the digit to be dropped is greater than 5, then the preceding digit should be increased by 1. So here, take one example. 2.746. If this is the case, now we want to round off this number up to 3 significant figure. That means 1, 2, 3. So that means we want to eliminate this number. So then what about this 6? 6 is greater than 5. So if the 6 is greater than 5, then according to rule, the preceding digit, that means this digit should increase by 1. That means 2.7. So this value increases by 1. So that means 7, 5. Now what is the significant figure? 3 significant figure. See here, this value is unchanged because this 2 is less than 5. But here 6 is greater than 5, so the preceding digit increased by 1. Now take one more example. In the first case, suppose if the number is given like this 2.123. Now we want to round off up to this value, up to 3 significant figure. Then what is the answer? 2. So we want to eliminate this 3, but the 3 is less than 5. So that means this 2 value remains unchanged. So the answer is 2.12. Now take one more example in case of second case. Suppose if the number is 2.12, the same example, instead of 3, now if I will choose 7, then so in this example, now we want to round off this 7. Then this 7 is greater than 5. Now the final answer is, since 7 is greater than 5, the preceding digit 2 increases by 1. That means this 2 becomes 3. So 2.13. So this is the answer. So this is the rule how to round off the digits. Suppose next third case, if the digit to be dropped is exactly 5. See, in first case, this digit is less than 5. In first case, this digit is less than 5. But in second case, this digit is greater than 5. Then third one is, if the digit is exactly 5, then how to round off the number? So that is third point. So that is, the rule is, the third point is, if the digit to be dropped is 5, so exactly 5, then the preceding digit is not changed if it is even. If the preceding, see, this preceding digit is, if it is even, then that is not changed if the digit to be dropped is 5. Example is, suppose 2.745. So here we want to drop this number because we want to get the final result with 3 significant figure. Now according to this rule, so the preceding digit, see, this preceding digit is even. Now we want to drop the 5. Now what is the final answer? So then the preceding digit is not changed if it is even. Since it is even, the number is remained same. So this is answer, simple. So take one more example. Suppose 2.125. Now in this case also, if we want to remove this 5, then what is the final answer? Since the preceding value is even, since it is even, the value remains same. So 2.12. So like that, if you take one more example, suppose if the number is 6.7425. Suppose we want to drop this 5, then the previous digit, the preceding digit is 2, which is even, so then the answer is 6.742 only. That means if you want to round off this digit up to 1, 2, 3, 4 significant figure. So like that, if the digit is 5, if the dropout digit is 5, then we will check the preceding value whether it is even. If it is even, it is unchanged. Next case, if it is odd number, then that is fourth case. So what is fourth case? If the digit to be dropped is 5, if the digit to be dropped is 5, then the preceding digit is raised by 1 or increased by 1. If it is odd, so now take one example. So suppose the same example here, if it is 2.735, now we want to round off this number up to 3 significant figure, that means up to this point only. So here the dropout digit, which is 5, and the preceding, just check the preceding, 3 is odd number. Since it is odd number, according to the rule, then this value increases by 1, that means 2.74 is the answer. So take one more example. Suppose if the number is 2.175 and we want to round off this number up to 3 significant figure, so this is also 3 significant figure, then so this is 5 and this is odd number, so what is the answer? 2.18. so this is the answer. So like that, we can round off the numbers. So right, next concept is rules for arithmetic operation with significant figures. So that means suppose we have two physical quantities, and one physical quantity is having 4 significant figure, and another physical quantity is having 3 significant figure. And suppose if these two physical quantities, if they are added or if they are multiplied, then what is the significant figure for the resultant physical quantity? So that's why we have certain rules for this part also. So the first one is, in case of multiplication or division. So the first one is, in case of multiplication and division. So that is first one. Right. So here, suppose the statement, the rule for this case is, the final result should retain as many as many significant figure as are there in the original number with least significant figure So that means so take one example. Suppose a mass is given, so mass M is given and which is measured as 4.237 grams, and one more physical quantity is also given, volume V, so that is 2.51 centimeter cube. Here what is the significant figure? Here the four significant figure, because 1, 2, 3, 4, so four significant figure. Here what is significant figure? 1, 2, 3, so three significant figure. Now in this case, what is density? So find the density with proper significant figure. Now density formula, so as we know, so density rho is equals to mass by volume, that is equals to 4.237 grams all divided by volume, means 2.51 centimeter cube. So that is equal to, so if you take this value, then you will get 1.688. Now you can raise a question here. See here, this M, the four significant figure, this value has four significant figure, this value has three significant figure, then what is the significant figure of the density? So then we will follow this rule. So the rule is, the final result should retain as many significant figure as are there in the original number with least significant figure. So which one is least, which one is having least significant figure here? Volume. So that is how much? Three significant figure. That means the answer should be three. But if you do this calculation, 4.237 by 2.51, then you will get approximately 1.688. 1.68804 gram per centimeter cube. But we want to, according to this rule, the final result should be with three significant figure. That means this one, this one, this one only. And of course here this value is greater than 5, so that means 1.69 gram per centimeter cube. Now what is the final result? The final result, in final result, the significant figure is how much? 1, 2, 3. Three significant figure. So here also volume has three significant figure. So that's why the final result should be three, with three significant figure. So like that, like in this way, we can solve the problem. So this rule is applicable for both multiplication and division. That means if the two physical quantities, if they are in multiplication or if there is a division, then you need to apply this rule. Next one is, suppose if the two physical quantities are added or subtracted, then what is the final result? So in case of addition and subtraction, so this is second one. So in case of addition and subtraction. So the rule is, so that is, the final result should be, the final result should be written as many decimal places as many decimal places as are there, as are there in the number, in the number with the least decimal places. So this is rule. So in first case, suppose if the two physical quantities are in multiplication or when they are in dividing, then we will follow the minimum significant rule. That means the final result should be written as many as significant figure as are there in the original number with the least significant figure. That is in case of multiplication. Whereas here you will check the decimal places. In first case we will check the significant figure, the minimum significant figure. Here we will check the decimal places. Suppose example. One example is, suppose a MOS is given M1, that is 436.32 grams, and one more MOS is given M2, that is 0.301 grams, and one more MOS is given, that is 227.2 grams. Now, what is total mass? Simple question. So how do we get the total mass here? By adding these all physical quantities. So the total mass is equals to M1 plus M2 plus M3. So that is equals to 436.32, 0.301, 227.2. So like that. You need to add. So when you are adding this, then how do you get here? See, this is, there is nothing number here. This also nothing is there. Nothing is there, right? Okay. So that means 1, 2, 3 plus 3, 6 plus 2, 8, and 6 plus 7, 13, and carries 1 here. So 3 plus 2, 5 plus 1, 6, and 4 to 6. Right. Now after applying this rule, what is the rule here? You need to retain as many as decimal places with least decimal places. So in this here, what, how many numbers are there? After decimal, how many numbers we have here? 1 and 2. Here 1, 2, 3. Here just 1. That means the least one is 1. After decimal, we have only one digit. Here we have two digits. In this case, 1, 2, 3 digits. So that means here after decimal, we have three digits. Here after decimal, here two. Here three digits. Here just one digit. That means the final answer should retain as just only one decimal point. One decimal, after decimal only one digit. That means the answer is 663.8 only grams. So we will neglect these two digits. So this is the rule. Suppose if take one more example. Suppose a length is given L1, that is 0.307 meters, and we have one more length, So that is the L2 is equal to 0.304 meters. Then in this case, what is the difference between these two length? So the difference between these two length is equals to L1 minus L2. That is equal to 0.003 meters. So after decimal 1, 2, 3. After decimal 1, 2, 3. That means the final result should be contained 1, 2, 3. So this is answer. Simple 0.003. So like that we will solve the problems based on these all rules. So now we will solve the a few problems. Now we will solve the fifth problem. So all of you check the fifth problem. A stick has length of 12.132 centimeter and another stick has the length of 12.4 centimeter. That means we have two sticks. The first stick, the length of the first stick is 12.132 centimeter. Second one is 12.4 centimeter. So we have two sticks. Fine. If the two sticks are placed end to end, what is the total length? Similarly, if the two sticks are placed side by side, then what is the difference in their length? So that means simply, suppose we have two sticks, these two sticks, first stick, second stick, let us assume. Then this stick length is 12.132, this stick length is 12.4. The first question, if the two sticks are placed end to end, that means if the two sticks are placed like this, then what is the total length? That is first case. The second case is, if the two sticks are placed side by side like this, the question is, what is the difference between these two lengths? So all of you note down the fifth problem. Right. Then, according to problem, here, according to problem, the first one is problem number 5. So let the length of the first stick is L1, which is given 12.132 centimeter, and the length of the second stick is L2, which is given 12.4 centimeter. So first one is 12.132, second one is 12.4 centimeter. Here after decimal, how many digits are there? 3 digits. Here after decimal, how many digits are there? 1. Okay, fine. Now, first case here. If two sticks are placed end to end, then what is the total length? The total length is L is equal to L1 plus L2. So that is equals to 12.132 plus 12.4. Now what is the answer here? So the answer is equals to 532. But according to rule, the final result should be contain only one decimal, because here L2 has the least decimal after one digit after decimal. So that means therefore L is equal to how much here? 24.5 centimeter. So that we will neglect this 3 and 2. This is the first case. Now second case. So this is case 1. Case suppose if the two sticks are placed side by side, if two sticks are, so this is answer here in first case. In second case, if the two sticks are placed side by side, then the difference in length is equals to, so let me take this is the L and this is L dash. So L dash is equal to how much here? L2 minus L1. Because this is 12.4, this is, okay, right. So that means 12.4 minus 12.132. Then if that is the case, so that means it implies 12.4, and this is 12.132. So this is 00. So if you subtract it, then how much you will get here? So 10, 2 means 8, and this is 9. So 9 minus 6. Sorry, 9 3 ante. That means here you will get 6. And this is 3, so that means 12.368 centimeter. This is L dash. But according to rule, this number having only one digit, so that means you need to take only this one. You need to eliminate all this. And moreover, L dash is equal to 12.3, but here, sorry, this is 0. This is also 0. So 0 point. So this is 3, 1, that means this is 2. Okay. So this is how much here? 268 centimeter. But you need to round off this number. So up to one decimal point. After a decimal, we will take only one digit. That means only 2. Because it is greater than 5, then we will round off up to 0.3 centimeter. So like that, you can solve the problem. So next one is problem, sixth problem. So all of you check the sixth problem. So here, problem sixth, that is, each side of a cube is measured to be 7.203 meters, and what is the total surface area and the volume of the cube to appropriate significant figure? So the question is, each side of a cube is measured to be 7.203. Okay, fine. What is the total surface area and the volume of the cube with appropriate significant figure? Sixth problem. Right. Now, according to problem, side length is given. So that is A, let the cube side length is A, which is given, that is 7.203 meters. So significant figure is how much here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means 4 significant figure. Now first case, they are asking what is total surface area of the cube. So total surface area, the formula is 6A square. That is equals to 6 into A square is how much here? 7.203 whole square. Okay. That means you will get 311.29 meter square. So here meter is there. So here what is the significant figure in this case? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But we want only 4 significant figure, therefore the total surface area is how much here? 311 point. So you need to take only 4 significant figure, so that means up to this point only, but since it is greater than 5, then we will raise one number here, that is 311.3 meter square. So this is 4 significant figure. This is the answer. Next one is second case. What is second case? Value, right? So the volume of the cube is equals to A power 3. That is equals to A value is how much here? 7.203 meters whole cube. That is equals to, so you will get 373.71 meter cube. So in this case, but we want to round off this number up to 4 significant figure, because A value is 7.203 only here. So that means value is equals to 373.7 meter cube. So because this number is less than 1, so just we will take the value only 7 only. So like that, what is the significant figure of this 4? 1, 2, 3, 4. So like that, in this way we can solve the remaining problems. So this is the today's class.